Hey, is that folk music that you play there? What is that? How do you call that folk music?
I think it was Studs Terkel who asked Big Bill Brunze, did he consider his blues music to be folk music? And Big Bill says, well, never heard no horse.
Memories of our childhood have begun to fade. Still some days I hear your laughter at some silly game we played. And I thought we had our whole lives till we grew old. But God had other plans for you, so I've been told. There were things I didn't do that I should have. There were things I didn't say that I could have. Now in your memory is a promise I make to you. To live like every day matters. It's easy to forget as the days and the years go by. Things I said I'd always remember and the reasons why. Said I'd treasure every moment, live every day. Like there is no tomorrow, cause no one can really say. Said I'd mean what I say when I say it. Take every card that I'm dealt and I'll play it. Cause I remember there's a way I should live my life. Like every day matters. Cause every minute that passes is gone and you never get it back again. You've got to live like you mean it, love like tomorrow may never come. Tried to teach my children things that you taught me. You said we're braver than we know, strong as we need to be. You never get that moment back once you let it go. Now I try every day to live the things. Every minute that passes.
Thank you.
The show is Horses Sing None of It. My name is Ralph Litwin, and our guest today is Karen Kamenetsky and friends.
That is true.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
You want to introduce us to your friends?
Certainly. We have Renee Paddock on the violin and Clark Paddock on the bass.
Hi, Clark.
And Phil Riff Landis on guitar.
Hi, Phil.
And I am Karen Kamenetsky.
We presumed. So that's a great song.
Thank you.
Is that the song that was inspired by your sister?
Yes, it is. That's the first song that I wrote that started this whole thing that snowballed into us playing together and recording a CD. That song.
Worthy.
Thank you.
What else would you like to share with us?
I'll take the cape off. I would like to play a song called Older Than I Thought I Was, which I am. C, right? Yeah, no, I just need to. I'm starting on what?
G.
Okay. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Even
45. And I know some things today that I wish I had known back then, Mike. Life doesn't always go the way you plan. Time slips through your fingers like sand. And you should do one thing that you love every day you're alive. And I'm gonna do one thing that I love every day I'm alive. Yes, I'm gonna do one thing that I love every day I'm alive.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Great.
Thanks.
So you're a pharmacist in real life.
In real life, I am, yes, a hospital pharmacist.
What hospital do you work at?
I work at Hackettstown Regional Medical Center in Hackettstown, New Jersey.
And what do they think about your music over there?
They're extremely supportive. They're very supportive. Today at lunch, I was outside sitting in the sun right smack in front of the hospital, outside the front door, practicing, playing all through all the songs. And excuse me, when I had my CD release party in November, I think about 10 or 12 people that I work with came, so it's
nice.
They're very supportive. Very supportive.
Great. What else would you like to play for us?
What did I say we were going to play third? Oh, my tomato song. This is a song that I wrote about a tomato, actually about Jersey tomatoes, to be exact. Yes. Okay. One, two, three, four. Doesn't have a first name, so I decided to call him Tom. I saw him sitting in the grocery store. I said, Tom, where are you from? He said, it's January. Did you think I grew outside in New Jersey? I was doing just fine in California till they ripped me from the vine too early. I said, Tom, I think we have a problem. 'Cause I want my tomatoes to come from New Jersey. I want them to ripen on the vine. I want to get them at the farm stand the day they bring the harvest in. I don't want to eat any other kind. Truck with a flat of strawberries and a case of romaine, just so you could pretend that the seasons don't exist, which, by the way, I think is insane. He says, January, why don't you eat a rutabaga or a red potato? I was bred to store and ship, so I'm merely pale and tasteless. I'm no Ramapo. I said, Tom, I have to agree. I want my tomatoes to come from New Jersey. I want them to ripen on the vine. I want to get them at the farm stand the day they bring the harvest in. I don't want to eat any other kind. And Tom said, you knew this day was coming and you could have been prepared. It's not that hard to do. There are many ways to preserve a tomato. Canning and freezing and drying, just to name a few. And then in January, you can take a jar down off the shelf and break the seal. Pull some roasted aromas out of the freezer. Have some dried tomatoes at every meal. Said Tom, I have to agree because I want my tomatoes to come from New Jersey. I want them to ripen on the vine. Thank you very much. Suffering from some allergies.
Yeah.
This evening.
Sorry to hear that.
Thanks.
But you sound good anyway.
Thank you.
That's true about tomatoes. They don't.
Absolutely.
They don't taste good in the winter.
Absolutely. Refuse to buy them. I just refuse to buy them. Yeah. Just. It's not the same. And since I wrote the song, I read a couple books, Tomato Land, another couple books about just how awful the conditions are for the people who are growing the tomatoes, or not growing them, but harvesting them in Florida. So even more reason, don't buy tomatoes in the winter. It's just not worth it. Wait for Tom in the summer.
Great. We should let folks know how they can find out about your recording and your activities, your musical activities.
Yes. Well, there's a the Reverb Nation page. I think it's my name at Reverb Nation. There's a CD Baby page where the CDs, the CD that I released in November is available. And Karen K. at mountainledgemusic.com is an email address, and I also have a Facebook page. That would be Facebook first, or I don't know.
Yeah, facebook.com slash Karen.
Slash.
Karen Kamenetsky Music.
Yeah, I'm too flaky to remember all those things, but they're all, if you search me on any of those sites, you will find me. Also YouTube. You can find us on YouTube too. There's some really good videos of a show we did last October, maybe?
A while back.
In Long Valley, that was stellar.
Great. We'll look you up on the web.
Okay. That's where you'll find us.
What else do you have for us?
Civil Conversation.
Yes.
Is that what I said?
Okay. Politically active song.
Yeah, this is my political anthem song. Okay. One, two, three, four. Just like Tom Paxton, I've been around this land. What I see frankly terrifies me, I just don't understand. How we went from disagreement to violence and rage. We let talk show hosts convince us we can never be on the same page. People calling themselves patriots, talking about revolution. Well, this is my country too, and I say we find a better solution. So take a step towards the middle, from the left or the right. Let's have a civil children going hungry, bridges that have fallen down, people without homes, people losing their jobs in every city and every town. Now instead of blaming those who do not vote the way you do, why don't you stop, take a look around, see if you can rebuild a bridge or two. One nation in visible, torn apart, we're not as strong. How can we ever defeat our enemies if we can't even get along? So take a step towards the middle, from the left or the right. Let's have a civil conversation about what you and
this great nation. But you don't have to agree with the government. You don't have to agree with me. You have the right to your own opinion. That's why we call it a democracy. Sometimes it's hard to find the common ground when all we see is red and blue. But I suspect you want some of the same things that I do. I want a safe place to raise my children, a chance to do some good in this world, and a feeling of pride in my heart each time I see that flag unfurl. So take a step toward the middle, from the left or the right, let's have a civil conversation about what you and I can do, whether we're red or we're blue, to make the difference in this great nation. But it's the greatest experiment ever begun. Fight for what you believe in with your vote, with your voice. Don't let anyone convince you that hate is the only choice. Let's work till all of us feel pride every time that flag's unfurled. Like Gandhi said, we need to be change we want to happen in this world. So take a step towards the middle, from the left to the right, let's have a civil conversation about what you and I can do, whether we're red or we're blue, to make the difference in this great nation.
Great. Well, 27 minutes is about run its course.
Okay.
Wow. So whatever you want to close up with.
Okay.
You can.
We're going to close up with Back in the Game, which is a song I wrote about my battle with rheumatoid arthritis. And we'll say, and do I capo that? No. Okay. One, two, three, four. Much for me. Every way I turn, you're standing between where I am and where I want to be. I try my best to ignore you and pretend that you just aren't there. I don't want to think into bouts of self-pity that leave me standing in the corner crying, this just isn't fair. Today I am gone.
bar.